When fire gutted the chapel of Tonbridge School in Kent in 1988, it destroyed the organ too. As fate would have it, although this large instrument was some 80 years old, it had only just been extensively restored, at some considerable cost. Not only was this all a tragedy for the school, but it also meant that organist Simon Preston, who lives locally, no longer had anywhere handy to practice on Mondays. But, in Phoenix fashion, a magnificent new chapel has risen from the ashes, and with Simon Preston's help and advice, a stunning new organ now perches on a gallery at the West End. It was built in 1995 by the Danish firm of Marcussen, and it's already attracted a huge amount of attention. Such is the demand that Simon Preston hardly gets to lay his fingers on it, the queue is so long. However, he did manage to record this programme for Radio 3. A little later, he'll be playing Mozart's Adagio and Allegro in F, and the suite by Maurice Durufle. But he begins with English music, The Paean by Kenneth Leighton. It's a piece Simon Preston knows well. He gave the first performance for the 40th anniversary of the Organ Club on the Royal Festival Hall organ in 1967. At Tonbridge School, The Paean gives an opportunity to show off two of the loud solo trumpet stops, the tuba near the beginning, and then towards the end of this five-minute piece, the brilliant horizontal trumpet enchumade, so powerful because there are two pipes to each note. The Paean by Kenneth Leighton, played by Simon Preston on the new organ in the chapel of Tonbridge School. Simon Preston's experience of different organs around the world has proved a good source of advice to the school about where to look for an organ builder and what kind of specification to choose. But in the end, it was very much up to the school. After all as well as the recitals and teaching that go on at Tonbridge, it remains primarily an organ for leading worship, accompanying a chapel full of schoolboy songsters. Marcussen has furnished them with a large instrument, 67 stops, 4 manuals and pedals, all with mechanical tracker action and the latest electronic gadgetry for keeping it all under control. But in fact, the organ looks as if it's neo-baroque. There are 2 cases, a smaller positive case in front of the main one, but looks can be deceptive.
I think that it's really totally a romantic instrument. I say that with some trepidation because, of course, if you look at the specification, it has all the trappings, if one can call it that, of Baroque parts. But really and truly, when it all comes together and when one's playing romantic works, then I think that's the essence of this organ. It's basically rich romanticism.
Simon Preston, and he continues with music for a mechanical instrument, in fact a totally mechanical clock organ. The Adagio and Allegro in F by Mozart. Mozart was in good company writing for this unexpressive and artificial musical instrument.
Oh, well, I don't think he wanted to make it artificially interpreted. He actually hated the whole thing, well, according to some letter or other. I think he actually wrote it for this mechanical clock thing, because actually a number of composers did. Beethoven did. He wrote 5 pieces for mechanical clock. Haydn wrote pieces for... Hummel wrote some. It was a sort of thing that everyone did, partly because the man who owned these mechanical clocks gave them quite a lot of money. And I think Mozart did financially quite well out of it, I think. But, in fact, Kochel 594 is such a deep piece. I know it has an allegro in the middle, which is almost Handelian in a way, but the opening adagio and the closing adagio, all the similar sections, they are really quite anguishing and beautiful.
Thank you.
The Adagio and Allegro in F, K594, by Mozart, originally written for a mechanical clock organ, but played there by Simon Preston. He concludes his recital from Tonbridge School Chapel with one of the finest organ works to come out of the 20th century, the suite by the Parisian organist Maurice Durufle. The three movements last 20 minutes, and it's a milestone for many organ students. If you can cope with the challenges of the Durufle suite, you're definitely in the Premier League.
It is that sort of piece. It's a Parnassus, I think, really. It's the acme, the peak. I think part of the problem is that Durufle's music is difficult, even when it sounds simple. The Sicilienne, which is the middle movement of the suite, sounds absolutely natural and beautiful and not at all difficult. And yet it's horrendously difficult with the stretches that you have, having to thumb out things on lower manuals, you know, which is really very hard work indeed. And of course the toccata is a very difficult piece of music. That there again is all over the keyboards all the time. It seems to stretch one to the ultimate limit. I find that the prelude is the piece that I come back to. It actually... It's so sad. The crescendo in the prelude is so cataclysmic, and it's a bit of a marathon in some ways. It's a long haul of really very difficult music, but very rewarding. And he is, I think, one of the finest composers of the 20th century for the organ. It's just wonderful.
Thank you. The Suite for Organ by Maurice, Durufle, played there by Simon Preston on the new instrument in Tonbridge School Chapel. Music for Organ was presented and produced by Tim Thorne.